Leo, hi. So this is going to be a reading for mid-December 2021. And I'll do the reading for you and then I'll close it off with the Oracle card. And these are general readings, so they may not resonate for all of you. If they do, there is an extended at the end of the video. You can check out all the info about that in the description box below if you want. Now let's see, Leo, what's up? Interesting. The overall energy for the reading, the Six of Cups. So this is tied up possibly to a soul connection of yours. Starting off the reading, you get the Judgment card crossed by the Five of Wands. There's a little bit of a tension here. There's a little bit of... that whole sense of impulsiveness tied up to this. That whole sense of rushing into... maybe saying some things, doing some things. It's coming in with an energy of like little kids playing, you took my toy, I'm not playing with you anymore kind of thing. But then, you know, 5 minutes later, oh, I'm sorry. Fuck the toy. Well, I hope kids don't talk like that, but you know what I mean? That kind of sense of rushed decisions here. In your focus, the Hierophant. This could be a commitment, this could be a marriage, this could be also tied up to certain beliefs that you may have, they may have, I don't know. In the recent past, the Seven of Swords, somebody kind of turning their back but not really going anywhere. In the, at least energetically, they're not. Physically, yeah, maybe they're in China and you're in Brazil, I don't know. In your Strength card, the Three of Swords, there's a little bit of pain here, but I feel like it's not necessarily working against you, this pain. It could be working in your favor in terms of maybe you're learning something out of this, you know, the way I get it from here. In the immediate future, the Knight of Wands, a little bit of an energy coming towards you by the looks of it. It's passionate, it's good, it's feeling good. Supporting this reading, the Ten of Pentacles. Again, I kind of get a sense that this is someone close to you in terms of someone you may have a commitment with. Something stable, something long-term here. The energy that surrounds you and you may not be aware of it, the Moon. Something is not revealed yet and I feel like it shouldn't be. Like whatever this experience may be, could be leading you who knows where, and you're not supposed to know yet where and why you're experiencing what you're experiencing. I kind of get it like that. In your hopes and fears, the Queen of Pentacles, starting to take care of yourself a little more. In the potential outcome, balance, the Justice card, balance is coming into play. So let's clarify. Let me clarify the Six of Cups. The Star, the Justice card, the Three of Wands. Quite interesting, because I see you wanting that balance that's coming into play. Kind of hoping for it. Maybe a little anxious because it's not here quite yet, where things are going to fall into place. It is coming. With the Three of Wands, it does seem to be here in the future, which is interesting because it showed up as the potential outcome for this. So you're shown up in the desire of that. Let me clarify the Judgment. Nine of Swords, Six of Cups, Nine of Pentacles. I kind of get a sense of separation here, a sense of, even though this is a commitment, even though two energies are creating a third energy and it's looking stable, it's looking good, there's something splitting this up, the two energies. But the third energy kind of stayed. It's still connected, it's still here. Because of this split that I'm getting, there's some pain attached to you, possibly. And from that pain, I feel like there's a little bit of conflict going on. So there's that tensed kind of energy here. Of course, this could be them, doesn't have to be you, but you would know. If it's you, for the Five of Wands, you get the King of Cups, the Three of Swords, the Seven of Wands. There's love and there's pain at the same time. And somebody's not dealing well with that pain in terms of, yeah, there's pain, I don't want it. Why is it here? Because it is. Just like the energy of love is here, so is the energy of pain. They're both energies. We're, you know, the labels that we give them, and because somebody said to us as we were growing up, hey, this is pain. It feels like shit. It's not good. It's icky. But what they forgot to mention while you were learning that is, sit through it. It's just a feeling. It's a feeling like the love one is. Why would you want to stay in the loved one for so long, but this one, it's your feeling, just like the loved one. Nobody taught us how to embrace them because they're ours, and then release them. You know, because the universe is gonna take care of all of that once we experience our own emotions. So yeah, I feel like it's one of those lashing out kinds of energy. Somebody's holding on to a little bit of pain here, and because they're rejecting that pain, they're kind of putting it out there in a more, let me get into an argument with you instead of me sitting through my own pain. Let me create this chaos here a little bit, because I'm hurting. Can't you see I'm hurting? No, because you can't, you know? So, let's do the Hierophant. Four of Pentacles, Wheel of Fortune, the Lovers. There is a sense of commitment here, as I said before. It does look like possible marriage. And there seems to be a little bit of a rough patch in this, but not something major, because I see things turning for the better, in a better direction here. So I don't know what these bugging energies are here. For the Three of Swords, you get the Strength card, the Sun, the Ace of Swords. There you are, with the Strength and the Sun. Leo showing up strong. That's basically you addressing your own pain. So if you've been through something here and you've been hanging on to an energy that's unpleasant, and instead of dealing with it, you actually went out there and kind of just put it out there because you're angry about something and you don't know what. So let me argue with anybody, everybody that's around me, especially this connection that's tied up to you. Let me do that. It's easier. So this is you kind of turning things back around and being like, it's my own shit. I need to deal with it on my own. I don't need to put it out there, you know, for others to deal with it. It's to the Knight of Wands. And the minute you do that, all of these energies are kind of changing here, to be honest. The Hierophant, the Magician, the Knight of Swords. Somebody's manifesting this movement. Someone's coming towards you energetically, and they are manifesting this. So not only are they moving, they want to. They're like, I'm coming. I don't know what their intention is. I just see a lot of determination and a lot of passion in their movement. Let's do the Ten of Pentacles. In the supportive energies, the Ace of Cups, the Seven of Swords, the Seven of Cups. There's a little bit of tendency of someone moving on, someone being like, you know what? I'm walking away from something that looks to be stable, feels as stable. There's love here. There's potential for love to be had and grown and, you know, explored here. But fuck that. I'm moving on. I don't know who's doing that. I feel like possibly if this is you in this place of pain, you might be in that place of kind of projecting onto this connection whatever you feel like you can't figure out in terms of your own pain. But again, I see the flip there. I see the determination. I see the Leo going out and being like, hold on, wait a minute. I got to deal with this, you know? Let's do the moon. Seven of Pentacles, Five of Pentacles, Ace of Wands. Leo, Leo, Leo. Something is going to hit you like a train, basically. There's an energy that's coming back. That's the energy you can't see because you're not supposed to see it yet until it comes. There's an energy from your past, possibly from a past situation that I do see as done. But it's resurfacing. It could be the energy tied up to the immediate future here. Because it's bringing in kind of similar vibe to the table. Okay. Let's see the Queen of Pentacles. The Five of Cups, the Empress, the Queen of Swords. Try to go back to yourself. There's a little bit of, there's something that's holding you back from standing in your own power. And it's something that's resurfacing as anger almost, as almost creating tensions here and there throughout your life. And it's in the way because you're right there with the Empress, but you're tied up to something from the past. And it's interfering with that place of self-care. It's kind of shutting you down at times emotionally too. I don't know what it is. I don't know the source of it. I just see it as shutting you down and creating this. It's not a lot, but it's there. It's subtle. It's an energy of, I feel riled up from the inside and I don't know why. So I'm going to take it out on the outside, on whoever's close here, whatever. You know, it's there. If you dig a little bit, you can find it because you have all the tools available here. Or you have the Empress, you have the Queen of Pentacles. That's you. That's turning your focus to you because it's there. It's not everybody and everything else around you annoying the shit out of you and you being like, ah. When that's the case, that's basically a signal for you to go back to you. Let's do the Justice card and the potential outcome. Come here. I promise you after Leo's extended, we're all gonna eat and sleep. All of us. For the Justice card, you get the Eight of Wands, the Eight of Swords, the Page of Swords. You're receiving something. There's an energy that's coming towards you. It could be through words this time around with the Eight of Swords, with the Eight of Wands. The Eight of Swords tells me that whatever it is that you're receiving is confusing you. And because of that, you're shown up in the Page of Swords in an energy of responding to this from a place of, I don't know. I don't know what to do about this. So I'm going to give to this, but not much because I have no idea what to give because I don't know what the hell is going on. So this energy that's coming your way seems to be a little bit confusing when it does show up, when it does bring in whatever it wants to bring. And in the hidden energy, it seems to be an energy from your past. So let's see what the universe has. Where is that sun? It's shining right off of a surface that's shining right in my face. In my eyes, actually, which is holy shit. That was kind of an extreme reaction, but it kind of ties everything up that I just spoke about. The Emperor, the Lovers, the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is attached to the energy in the immediate future that's approaching you. You're with the Empress right there, and the Emperor is coming your way, basically. This is a connection that at some point, even now possibly, means a lot to you. I don't see it here. I don't see you in this connection right now. Maybe you are, but for the most part, I see it as something from your past, something that was left in the energy of this is done, we're done here. I'm not even sure if that was, even if it was said, I don't sense the wrapping up kind of part to it. So I see it coming back. Okay, that's it. Let's close it off with the Shaman's Dream Oracle. We'll see what the shaman has to say as a final word, and then I'll read a little bit about it, and then we're done. What is this? Me talks. That's interesting. Repairing the body, mind, spirit. So detox, me talks, me talks. That's interesting. Yeah, you'd need a little bit of me talks, especially with this energy you're carrying here, which I don't know what the hell the source of that is, but let's read. Let's see what's up. Metox appears as a warning that you can no longer postpone the self-care and pampering you long for. The time is now. Do healthy maintenance on your body before you have to make repairs that you will never quite recover from. Metox has come to caution you that it is not too late, but you are at the 11th hour. Do not deprive yourself of the health you deserve. I feel like it's referring to that energy you're carrying, because if you don't address it, eventually it'll grow and it'll become, like Metox says, something not unrepairable, but something harder to deal with. So, unrepairable, is that a word? Anyways, that's what I have for you, Leo. Hope this helped, and I'll see you next time.